Hey everyone, this is Dusty with a brief video lecture focused on the differences between artifacts and ecofacts and the concept of context within archaeology. First, we'll start with artifacts. Artifacts are defined as objects that were purposely manufactured or modified by humans for a specific task. Here, we have two stone projectile points, a stone bowl that might have been used for processing some sort of food item, ceramic sherds, and a glass bottle. In contrast to artifacts, these are ecofacts. Ecofacts can be defined as items that were not manufactured or modified by humans, but yet are still culturally relevant. Here we have an abalone shell, a deer skull, and some fish bones. If we found these in an archaeological site, these could be related to some type of past subsistence activity. Now here is where things get tricky. This is an unmodified deer antler. This is an ecofact. However, if we take the stone tool, an artifact, and whittle on the antler and modify it to, say, use in leatherwork or in basketry, this ecofact then becomes an artifact. That's right. The next thing I want to touch on is the idea of context. Context is a broad concept, so today I just want to focus on provenience and associations. Provenience refers to where archaeological materials were found. It can be very broad, a geographical area, it can be an archaeological site, and it can be a horizontal or vertical access of where materials were found. Context and provenience is critical to help us formulate interpretations within archaeology, because finding an artifact, such as this projectile point, without context, the story is very limited. If we know where it was found within a site, how deep it was, we might be able to interpret how old it is, cultural associations, and its function. Associations are also critical. Like I just said, just finding a projectile point, can't tell much of a story. Was this used for hunting? If so, what kind of animal? Could have been used for warfare? Absolutely. Could have been hafted in a handle and used for cutting? We don't know. Now, if we find a projectile point in association with something like a deer skull, especially maybe if it was embedded in the deer skull, now this tells more of a story. Then we can talk about how some type of past culture was using this specific artifact class to hunt large game, in this case, deer. Please, if any of these concepts are still vague, do not hesitate to contact me directly. Artifacts, ecofacts, and context are also outlined in great detail in the article, How Archaeology Works. Hopefully this helps. Have a great day.